The sixth round of talks between agitating farmers and the central government ended with a slight ray of hope, with the latter agreeing to two of the four main demands while deciding to meet again on January 4th to deliberate on the critical issues of repeal of farm acts and legal guarantee for minimum selling price. Sources said on the main demand for repeal of the three farm acts passed by the parliament in September and legal guarantee for MSP, which was the first two of the four charter of demands pushed by the agitating farmers' unions, the centre proposed constituting a committee, a final decision on which is expected in the next meeting. The Supreme Court too, which is hearing a petition related to the farmers' agitation, has said in one of its observations that a panel comprising of farmers' leaders, government officials and independent experts could be constituted to break the deadlock. Thousands of farmers from Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and some other states are protesting against the three farm laws. Even after 24 hours of continuous burning, the wildfire that broke out in Zuku Range showed no sign of abating as it raged on Wednesday evening at the main entry point from Viswama village here. Although Saranangami Youth Organization volunteers along with forest rangers were stationed at strategic locations to monitor the fire, there was very little they could do to control it as the strong gust of wind blowing out from Zuku Valley made the fire spread more fiercely and rapidly. As part of his planned visit, Nagaland Governor R.N. Ravi, along with his family, visited the valley on Wednesday. They had to traverse along a bypass route to get back to his entourage stationed at parking camp on the foothills because the raging fire had engulfed most of the main trekking path after they went into the valley. Saranangami Youth Organization Vice President K.C. Saleh said the organization was contemplating to seek the help of NSDMA, Air Force and others if the fire continues to burn at this rate. Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, BPCL, a Fortune 500 oil refining, exploration and marketing PSU with Maharatna status, has taken a revolutionary step in fuel delivery by inaugurating the first door-to-door delivery facility named Fuel Cart Fuel on Call in the state of Nagaland on December 30th. The door-to-door delivery facility was inaugurated for commercial sales by Mausam S. Khound, Territory Manager, BPCL Shillong Territory, in the presence of Prithviraj Nath, Sales Officer BPCL, and customers and esteemed guests through a launch function held at MK Assertion Center, Sipama in Dimapur. The facility comprises of a state-of-the-art automated mobile dispensing browser which has an inbuilt dispensing unit. The browser has a 6,000-litre capacity tank fitted on a vehicle and is licensed to provide door delivery of diesel to customers. To help the local small-scale producers and traders of northeastern region, Northeast Frontier Railway has decided to grant 30% discount in 8 time-tabled parcel special trains, reported the Sentinel Assam. This discount will be initially applicable up to March 31, 2021 and thereafter will be reviewed for extension every 6 months depending on the utilization of the parcel space. This discounted rate will enable producers and traders to transport their produce and goods to various parts of the country in a more reliable, faster and cheaper way. It is likely to provide them with a competitive edge in terms of timely and cost-effective delivery of their products or goods. The timetabled parcel train service were introduced during the nationwide lockdown to provide reliable time-bound services to courier services, e-commerce companies and other transporters. After reviewing the services, it might be extended for every 6 months depending on the utilization of the parcel space. The Assam Assembly declared Bodo as the associate official language of the state. The declaration comes after the Assembly passed the Assam Official Language Amendment Bill on the third of its 3-day winter session. As per reports, the amendment bill was introduced on the floor of the Assembly on December 28 by Assam Parliamentary Affairs Minister Chandra Mohan Patowari on behalf of Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal. Earlier on December 22nd, the Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal led Assam Cabinet, sat in a meeting and decided to approve the bill in the Assembly session. The statement of objects and reasons of the bill stated that the Bodo language, written in Devanagari script, now becomes an associate official language of Assam for all or any kind of official purposes. Like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for news that matters and stories that inspire.